Hi, if you're on a benzodiazepine, you need to listen to this. What is BIND? Find out about it here. Okay, so we're going to talk about benzodiazepine-induced neurological dysfunction. And I think we need to emphasize that it's not just a phenomenon associated with rapid withdrawal. Benzodiazepine-induced neurological dysfunction, in its broadest sense, can include the cognitive impairment that is associated with long-term benzodiazepine use, withdrawal from benzodiazepine use, and then the persistence of symptoms beyond cessation, which can last up to 42 months. So bear that in mind when I'm thinking about what we call benzodiazepine-induced neurological function, otherwise known as BIND, BIND. So bear that in mind when we are discussing BIND. Now let's go to, first of all, the concept of BIND during maintenance therapy with benzodiazepines. A senior colleague of mine said to me once, when I was in training, that anyone who's on the equivalent dose of benzodiazepines, of diazepam, 15 milligrams a day, is cognitively impaired in the same way that they would be if they were suffering from a mild acquired brain injury. So 15 milligrams of diazepam is the equivalent of a mild brain injury. So the evidence for this comes from a number of studies, but I'm going to give you the information from one study. So a study published in 2004, actually, so 21 years old now, stated that for those who are on a mean dose of diazepam equivalent of about 17 milligrams a day, so between 15 and 20 milligrams of diazepam a day, they experienced cognitive impairment in every single domain tested. And these were the domains, right? Sensory processing, psychomotor speed, nonverbal memory, visuospatial awareness, speed of processing, problem solving, attention and concentration, verbal memory, general intelligence, motor control and performance, working memory, and verbal reasoning. That's horrendous. Medications that are used in the long term to treat people who may have anxiety or some other anxiety-related issue, who are not cognitively impaired, end up with all of those neurological impairments. And I'm going to quote you a line from the study. It said, the results indicated that current long-term benzodiazepine users were significantly impaired in all the cognitive domains measured, including sensory processing, psychomotor speed, nonverbal memory, visuospatial processing, speed of processing, problem solving, attention, concentration, verbal memory, general intelligence, motor control, performance, working memory, and verbal reasoning. That's shocking. Now, the next thing that is shocking is that even if you wean off benzodiazepines, this is what happens. In another study, following withdrawal, significant impairment in many areas of cognition, i.e., verbal memory, psychomotor speed, speed of processing, motor control and performance, visuospatial processing, general intelligence, attention concentration, and nonverbal memory, persisted. When benzodiazepine users were followed up after withdrawal, i.e. after a maximum of 42 months post-withdrawal, cognitive deficits persisted. 42 months after withdrawal. So that's 24th, 36th. That's three and a half years after stopping benzodiazepines. People were experiencing significant symptoms, right? And in particular, the symptoms that were identified as being impaired included recent memory, processing speed, visio construction, divided attention, working memory, and sustained attention. So we've got the situation now where we've got very good evidence that benzodiazepines during use impair your cognition as if you were suffering from at least a mild acquired brain injury. And we've also got very good evidence that even coming off benzodiazepines up to 3.5 years later, 42 months after cessation, people are still suffering from significant cognitive impairment. Now, what happens during withdrawal? So during withdrawal, benzodiazepine-induced neurological dysfunction was introduced as a term to highlight the specific symptoms that occurred during withdrawal. And some of these symptoms included the following. And bear in mind, these are new symptoms not related to the original symptom that necessitated the original use of the benzodiazepine, right? So this is new. Coming off benzodiazepines can cause physical symptoms including, and I'm going to read this out, anxiety and agitation, insomnia, muscle tension or stiffness, tremors, sweating, headaches, nausea, vomiting, dizziness or lightheadedness, and heart palpitations. New psychological symptoms included increased anxiety. Now remember, this is new anxiety. So this would have occurred in someone who wasn't started on benzodiazepines for a primary anxiety disorder. So increased anxiety, depression, irritability, cognitive impairment. There's that old chestnut again. Panic attacks coming off benzodiazepines. And then severe symptoms, which are noted to occur in the cases of long-term use, coming off benzos after long-term use or after abrupt withdrawal, seizures, delirium characterized by acute confusion, disorientation, and an inability to think clearly. Hallucinations, so seeing things that others don't see, and psychosis, this detachment from reality. And in those who experienced symptoms during withdrawal, there were post-acute withdrawal syndromes, pause. So these are symptoms that persist after the withdrawal is completed, including prolonged anxiety and depression, cognitive issues, including long-lasting difficulties with memory, focus, or thinking clearly, and ongoing sleep disturbance, including insomnia, vivid dreams. So we've got the range of symptoms that can occur associated with the use of benzodiazepines. We've got symptoms that occur, or cognitive impairment that occurs during use. We've got a range of symptoms that occur during withdrawal and which persist beyond the point of cessation. And then we've got a range of cognitive symptoms that persist for up to 3.5 years, 42 months after cessation. So what are the risk factors for this happening? So we've identified a number of risk factors. The first one is long-term use. So chronic use of benzodiazepines increases the likelihood of developing neurological dysfunction. Stands to reason. High doses, again, stands to reason. We're talking about the benzodiazepine load. So taking higher than prescribed doses can lead to more severe cognitive and neurological impairment and can also lead to substance use disorder, benzodiazepine use disorder, otherwise known as dependence. People who are elderly, so the elderly seem to be more susceptible to bind as they may have slower metabolism of the drugs and also increased sensitivity to the drugs. And people who are using multiple medications, polypharmacy, so taking other medications that also affect the central nervous system in particular, that can increase your risk of bind. And drugs such as sedative antidepressants or opioids can be listed in that category of risk factor drugs. And bear in mind, so these would be drugs that would be treating insomnia. So we've talked about the experience of patients around benzodiazepine-induced neurological function, and we've introduced this idea of the risk factors for bind. That's all for today, folks. My name's Dr. Fergal Armstrong, and this has been Cracking Addiction.